There it is, boys. It's finally upon us. The Grand Theft Auto 3 Definitive Edition. I finally got my hands on it. So without further ado, let's get into the playthrough. I never realized she also killed that other dude. Well, I never really played GTA 3. At least not the story, so it's new for me as well.
Liberty City is in shock today as the police and emergency services deal with the aftermath of a devastating attack on a police convoy this morning. As yet, no details have been released about the prisoners being transferred in the convoy, and no group has claimed responsibility. The convoy left police headquarters early this morning for a routine transfer of felons to Liberty Penitentiary. The attack took place on the Callahan Bridge, leaving few witnesses and the bridge itself severely damaged. Some of the convicts are thought to have perished in the explosion that followed the initial attack. Revelations as to the professionalism of the attack struck police hours afterward, when identification of the missing felons were further hampered by an attack by computer hackers on police headquarters databases. With the Porter Tunnel project falling behind schedule, this disaster leaves Portland isolated from the rest of the city.
Come on! Señor Dickhead! It's no problem to kill you.
This actually looks pretty good, except for the rain.
Aye, get lost.
All right, let's go. Jeez, it's been a while. It's been a really long time since I played GTA 3. But it looks damn good. And I like that they kept the old style. It didn't have a minimap at first, I think. So that's new. Makes it easier as well. View distance, way higher. And believe it or not, but I actually have quite some lag, so I'm gonna change that up in the graphic settings real quick. But here we are. Home sweet home.
This is the place right here. Let's get off the street and find a change of clothes.
That sounds like a good idea. So I played every GTA game, I guess, or except GTA London maybe, and GTA 2. But I completed all the stories. But I never played GTA 3 the story, just a few missions. And you couldn't look around you, so that's a real nice feature that you can actually do this now. But let's go. Well, it looks pretty good. I changed the graphics up a little bit, but the lag isn't really going away, so I guess it's just part of the early versions of this game. Maybe it gets patched in the future. Let's hope. Or my PC just sucks. Could also be it.
Wait here, man, while I go in and talk to Luigi.
Paintball's got some business upstairs. Well, maybe you could do me a favor. One of my girls needs a ride, so grab a car and pick up Misty from the clinic, then bring her back here. Remember, no one messes with my girls. So keep your hands on the wheel. If you don't mess this up, maybe there'll be more work for you. Now get out of here.
All right, we got our first job. Get a vehicle. Well, that's gonna be this one. Pick up Misty. Well, we can do that. I think most of the YouTubers playing it are using a controller and I am using my mouse and keyboard. I don't know why, but I thought it would be easier to aim. Hi, Misty. Well, hi, my name is Cloud. Oh. Nice. Insane stunt. Let's go! Oh, did I nail it? I fucking nailed it, mate. Oh, god damn it. Oh, in the early games, the car explodes when you're on your back, and it still happens. Misty, get the fuck out! Misty? Oh, she's fine. Let's take this one. Bit of a rough start, but let's go. Game looks really fresh. Mission passed. 1500 bucks. Not bad, not bad. For just a delivery. Yeah, well. Let's just go in this mission again. See what they got for us now. Don't. Okay. Please don't demonetize me, YouTube. I'm not gonna say the title.
Luigi said to give you this, so here, take it.
There's a new high on the street. Goes by the name of Spank. Some wise guy's been introducing this trash to my girls down Portland Harbor. Go and introduce a bat to his face. Then take his car, respray it. I want compensation for this insult.
Jeez, guy, relax. We can handle it. Fuck off with the horn. Let me just take this car. Oh. Ooh, the bat. The classic bat from GTA 3. It's all coming back now. Let me know in the comments what your favorite GTA was. I bet most of you guys will say GTA 5. Or maybe GTA 4, since that one is being hyped up lately. I think mine still has to be Vice City, just because of that 80s atmosphere. San Andreas, you could do a lot of things, so that one is pretty close in the top 3 as well. Now that I'm really thinking about it, I think Vice City, just because of the atmosphere, because gameplay wise it wasn't that good. And GTA 5, well, it's actually a pretty good game, despite the hate it's getting. Was that all you got? Okay. But no, GTA 3, I never really played that much. But it was the first game that was actually from... how do you call it? Third person, instead of the top-down view. So that was a big change for gaming industries. So I also think GTA was a little late with these kind of games. Because you had games like Mafia and... I think a bunch of other games as well. But GTA was still from the top down, so it's actually pretty amazing to see that GTA was gonna get so big, because they weren't the first ones to do this. If I remember correctly, that is. But let me know in the comments what your favorite GTA game is. New engine and paint job, the cops won't recognize you. But I don't want a pink car. Oh well, it's not my car. But no, I gotta say GTA 5 is one of my best GTA games as well. Because if you think about it, when I played GTA 4, I was constantly complaining about the cops being too bad. There weren't any countryside or planes to fly, and GTA 5 had all of those, so... People like to hate games because it's new, and they have that nostalgia childhood feeling, but... I don't know, I'm kind of getting to see through it. Oh, he's doing the iconic gesture. Bat on his shoulder. Nice, nice. Let's go.
Hey, I gotta talk to you. All right, Mick, I'll talk to you later. How you doing, kid? The Don's son, Joey Leone. He wants some action from his regular girl, Misty. Go pick her up at Hepburn Heights, but watch yourself. That's Diablo turf. Then run her over to his garage in Trenton and make it quick. Joey ain't the kind you keep waiting. Remember, this is your foot in the door. So keep your eyes on the road and off Misty.
Roger that. Oh, you actually have the old cameras still. Like this to look left, this to look right, and this to behind. Those were the only camera settings you had back in the day. But now you have this. And that's a really cool feature. I'm glad they added that. Misty, your ride is here. Oh, she actually runs to the car now. That's nice. A driver you can trust. Okay, you've only seen me like one time and I already ran over like four guys, but okay. That's the best taxi driver Liberty City has to offer. So be it. So now I'm not playing on the highest graphics because that lagged insanely, but I still have lag, so I might as well just put it on the highest graphics again. But let's do that later. The game looks pretty clean. Joey's auto painting. Can't remember any of those missions.
Joey! Am I gonna get to play with your big end again?
I'll be with you in a minute, Sparkplug. Hey, I'm Joey. Luigi said you were reliable, so come back later. There might be some work for you. All right?
Well, let's hop back in right away.
Hey, I'm bored. When you gonna drill me?
In a moment, sweetheart. I got a little business to take care of. I got a little job for you, pal. The Ferrelli brothers have owed me money for too long and they need to be taught some respect. Lips Ferrelli is stuffing his fat face in the St. Mark's Bistro, so steal his car and take it to 8 Ball's bomb shop up in Harwood. You know 8 Ball, right? Once he's fitted it with a bomb, go park the car where you found it. Then sit back and watch the whole show. But hurry up, you won't be eating forever.
So we're going to Sonny's place. That's interesting. If we could kill Sonny now, that would save Tommy Fuseli a lot of trouble. Or is this game set? Oh, this game is set after Vice City, I guess. Yeah, because this is nowhere 80s, right? Nah. So Tommy Vercetti is already an old guy when we play this. And I also don't know if this is like the same timeline as GTA 4. Because this game came out in like, what was it, 2003 or something? GTA 4 2008, so I guess Cloud would still be around in GTA 4. Don't mind me, just a cab, parking right next to you and stealing your car. That's a nice looking car. Take Ferrelli's car. Oh, this is Ferrelli's car. That's sick. Oh, let's blow it up. Oh, that was a cop. Oh, fuck. They're trashing the vehicle, get it repaired. Oh, fucking hell, I thought I could have repaired it there. I need to drive more careful. They totally didn't see me drive up here. Okay, so I turn on V-Sync and that seemed to did the trick. So it's oh my god, are you fucking kidding me? Oh, I just got here. Why can't I drive for shit? This is gonna be like 200 episodes for just me still crashing my car in the third mission. And then finally making it to 8 Ball's repair shop. or bomb shop, whatever it's called. All the money I had earned, all spending it on this fucking paint job shit. Thank you very much. Now let's go. A Ball's repair shop, here we are. So now I can put a bomb under my car. That's nice. Armed with a bomb. Press R, bomb will go off when engine is started. Okay. Well, let's not press that button then, shall we? Well, you don't have first person. I remembered people asking that. If the game was gonna have first person, but it doesn't. Now, it's actually just GTA 3 like I remember it, so nothing has really changed besides the graphics and the modern controls, so looking around you and I think the shooting and the weapon wheel as well, but nothing much beside that. Maybe some cool little Easter eggs, but I don't know. Bomb arms. Okay, let's fucking go, mate. That's a very slow walk. It's building up the tension. Don't mind the cab just casually standing next to your car. Eat till you explode. Well. No, my cab. Okay, we're gonna go to Luigi again. Do a couple more missions for this episode. And I think that's about it. Don't want to make too long episodes.
Some Diablo scumbag has been pimping his scuzzy bitches in my backyard. Go and take care of things for me. If you need a piece, go around back of Abner Nation opposite the subway.
Now that's what I'm talking about. We can finally buy some guns. And I can check out the weapon wheel. Oh, the rain looks better now than it was in the intro. And me and it. I can't drive for shit, man. Hello.
Luigi said you'd need a piece. So go around the back of the shop. I left you a 9 in the yard.
Left you a 9 in the yard. I don't have to buy. Okay, nice. Oh, here it is. Tap to open. Oh, this is very nice. Just like GTA 5. Oh, and the aiming as well. Ah, this looks actually pretty cool. You can't see shit through this rain, man. I didn't know if I had to do that, but I probably didn't. Okay, let's go. Okay, my leg is completely back. But look at those reflections, my man. Jeez. You know, my PC is just getting old. Really need a PS5 or something. Oh boy. What was the objective again? Do I need to kill them? Oh, Jesus. How do I crouch? Jesus, that was... How do I crouch? I don't know. Wait, you can't crouch in this game. Oh. What's that? The pistol is now in store. Oh, in stock at Emanation. Okay, I got it. I did get a shotgun though, so that's nice. Let me just check real quick if you can actually crouch in this game, because... I can't remember. Stealth, left control. What do you mean stealth? Can you crouch? Oh, you mean walk. Okay. If that's stealth. Looking like a gangster is apparently stealth these days. I'm gonna take their car because it looks quite nice. And let's park it in the garage. Damn. It looks pretty nice. The game, I mean. The car as well. Park it up there. And let's save the game. Slot 1 is free. Okay, nice. Okay guys, thanks for watching. Episode 2 is coming fairly quickly, I guess. And we're going to make this into a series. So we're going to play GTA 3, then GTA Vice City, and then San Andreas. And why not just make it a whole road to GTA 6, and we put GTA 4 behind that as well, and then GTA 5. Because I never really played that story as well on my channel, which is kind of weird because I'm a GTA 5 channel. Anyway, thank you for watching. Leave a like, leave a comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.